Report Program Generator, or RPG as it is popularly known, was introduced by IBM in the early 60s. It was designed to provide a quick solution for generating reports. Most report generation programs consists of a fixed cycle of read, calculate, write operations. RPG includes a fixed logic cycle that will automatically perform these steps. Now, programmers were not required to specify each processing step that was required. Rather, their job was to describe the files, record layouts, calculations, and output required from the program. The RPG compiler would supply the missing steps to create an executable program. Another unique feature of RPG is its extensive use of indicators, a predefined set of variables that could take on one of two values, 0 or 1, corresponding to a logical off or on. RPG has evolved over the years into RPG-2 and then into RPG-3 for the System 38 computer. The introduction of the AS/400 in 1988 saw a new version of RPG in the form of RPG-400. This was followed by the release of RPG-4 in 1994 as part of IBM's Integrated Language Environment. Over the years, RPG has undergone many changes. It now includes features necessary for developing interactive applications such as operations for looping and decision, logic in keeping with structured program, design techniques, methods for calling other programs and passing data between them to support modular programming. Let us begin by studying a sample program. We have an item master file that contains the following fields: item description, quantity in hand, quantity ordered, and order date. We need to write an application program in RPG-400 that will produce a monthly sales report like the one that you see here. Here is a sample program that will generate the required report. Let us study the RPG program. RPG program consists of a set of specifications that have to appear within a fixed sequence within the program. Each specification has a different identifier or form type which must appear in position 6 of each program line. Each of these specifications serves a different purpose. The file description specification, for example, is used to identify the files used by our program. Entries in each program line have to appear in fixed positions or columns, as you can see in the coding sheet. A file description specification must include an F in column 6. Let us look at the file description specifications. As we just saw, a file description specification begins with an F in column 6. It is used to describe the files we will be using in our programs and to define how the files will be used. In columns 7 to 14, we enter the names of the files we will be using. That is, the database file item which contains the required data and a printer file that we will be using to produce our reports. In RPG, file names can be up to 8 characters long, should begin with an uppercase alphabet, dollars, hash or at the rate. The remaining characters can be uppercase alphabets, numbers, dollars, hash, at the rate. Cannot have embedded blanks. Remember that it is best to avoid using the special characters as they belong to the national language character set, which could differ from country to country. In position 15, we specify the file type, that is, whether the file is going to be used for input, output, combined input, output or update. We will designate the database file as input since we will only be reading records from it. Similarly, we will be writing to the printer file, so we will specify O for it. For input files in position 16, we specify whether the records will be retrieved explicitly by the RPG program or that the RPG logic cycle will be used. An F indicates full procedural processing, that is, the records will be read explicitly. When using the RPG logic cycle, one of the files should be designated as a primary file and the other files as secondary files. The entry in column 19 specifies the file format. It can be either F for fixed format, where the records will be described within the program, or E for externally described files. Most AS400 applications use externally described files. Here, we will use both externally described database file as well as printer file. Next, we come to position 40 to 46, which are used to specify the device form which to access the file. Here, for the item file, we specify disk and printer for the printer file. This completes the entries required in the file specifications. We shall see some more entries later.
Next comes the input specifications. It is identified by an I in column 6. Here, we describe the records as well as the fields in the records for the program described files. We shall see this section in a later chapter. The next set of specification is the calculation specifications, where we describe the processing that is required. The operations that we want to perform are print header, read each record and print a detail line until the end of the file. Here is the RPG code that performs the required processing. Let us look at the calculation specifications. Here we code an C in column 6. The operation to be performed is coded in column 28 to 32. Depending on the operation being performed, you can have entries in column 18 to 27 referred to as factor 1, columns 33 to 42 referred to as factor 2, and columns 43 to 48 referred to as the result field. The first step is to print the heading at the top of the page. We do this using the write operation. In factor 2, we specify the name of the record format in the printer file. Next, we read each record from the database file and print it. To read a record, we code the read operation in columns 28 to 32 and the name of the file or the record format in factor 2. In position 58 and 59, we code a two-digit number, in this case 90. This is an indicator. RPG provides a set of 99 indicators from 1 to 99. These are the character variables with two possible values, 0 and 1 or off and on. Indicators are used to signal the result of an operation. If the read operation encounters an end of file condition, the indicator 90 will be turned on. RPG provides three positions for specifying indicators. Column 54 and 55, 56 and 57, 58 and 59. Next, we establish a loop with the do while and undo operations that will keep reading records and printing them until the end of file is reached. The do while statement is coded along with a relational operator. Indicator 90 will set to 1 when there are no more records in the file. So we say do while indicator 90 is equal to 0. To access an indicator as a field, we prefix it with a star in as shown here. Within the do loop, we print each record that has been read and then proceed to read the next record. When all the records have been read and printed, we exit from the do loop. We then set on the last record indicator LR. This tells the system to close the open files and free up the memory used by the program. If we exit without setting on the last record indicator, some of the resources used by the program will continue to be tied up even after the program stops running. The last set of specifications that we have is the O specifications, which is used for describing the output. There has to be one set of O specification for every program describe output file. We shall see this section in the coming chapters. Let us take a look at the different specifications available in RPG. We have the control specification identified by a H in column 6, the file description identified by an F, the extension specification identified by an E, the line counter specification identified by an L, the input specification identified by an I, the calculation specification identified by a C, and the output specification identified by an O. Within an RPG program, the specifications have to appear in this order. However, the order of the extension and the line counter specification can be interchanged. The control specification provides the compiler with information about the program, such as the name of the program, the date format used by the program, whether an alternative correlating sequence or file translation is to be used. The file description specification as we have already seen, describes all the files used by the program. It contains the following information for each of the files: name of the file, how the file is to be used, size of the records in the file, input and output device used for the file. The extension specification describes record address files, table files, and array files used in the program. The line counter specification describes the page or form on which output is to be printed. Here, you include information such as the number of lines per page, the line of the page where overflow occurs. When coding an RPG program, SEU provides a prompting facility to help us in coding the different specifications. For example, entering IPC in the sequence number column will prompt us for the C specifications. Enter IP followed by a question mark to get a list of all available specifications. Summary. In this chapter, we looked at some of the features of RPG 400. We saw how it is a fixed format programming language and also looked at the different specifications that are used to code an RPG program. We also saw how a simple program could be written in RPG.